I remember that we had the high school party. I saw a guy who was doing this breakdance stuff. Then from there, I was like, wow, this looks cool. Then I was like, I have to try this.
Before I started breakdance, I was just acrobatic. Then I met the guys from Congo. They were doing breakdance. So I was shocked to see someone spinning on his head. Other one was spinning on his back. So it's like it inspired me.
Breakdance, that's the stuff that you know from the US music videos, the underground hip-hop battles that shaped the 1980s dance scene. But it's also caught the fascination of dancers in Kigali. Amani Mahoro and Ugandan-born Alex Sabagala are its pioneers. They've competed internationally, started their own breakdance festival, but they still have a few hurdles to overcome. The Kimisagara Youth Center in Kigali is the spot where Alex and Amani have created a community of b-boys and b-girls. From newcomers to experienced dancers, everybody's welcome.
When you start to break, it's a kind of introduction for yourself, like, yo, this is me, and I'm here at the floor, you know? So it's, I would say it's the first step that you have to do.
We are always here at the youth center to work, to gain more experience, but that's our work. We love to dance. The art is part of us.
With its free form, the dance lends itself to just about everybody. And in 2019, the crew started encouraging differently abled to join them.
So starting doing like a mobilization to move in the area, looking for the people with disability on the streets. Yeah, some of them, they were beggar on the streets. Others were just staying in their home without going anywhere.
What was supposed to be a month course ended up with the establishment of the Kubasha Dance Crew and a performance at the Kigali Breaking Cypher Festival.
They did an amazing performance. Everyone was shocked and people cried.
That's it.
I chose dance for three reasons. One, it is therapeutic. Two, sometimes when I take too long without doing sports and dance, my body stiffens. I've also gained confidence and self-esteem. Before, I was too shy to perform in front of people. But because of dance, I am no longer afraid.
Once a year, Alex and Amani organize the Kigali Breaking Cypher Festival, which includes dancers from all over the world. But the dancers' activities aren't only confined to Rwanda. Competitions outside East Africa introduce them to another level of breaking.
World Breaking Championship, that's where I got like a chance to travel for the first time in China. Those best b-boys in Europe, they were there. And I was going to compete with them. So it was... Yeah, I was nervous, but I said, yeah, I know I do their thing, but I'm representing Rwanda, so and East Africa in large, so I have to do my best.
Rwanda has no official breakdance federation, and so while breakdance itself is making its debut at the Olympics in 2024, these dancers weren't able to compete for the qualifiers, but the team are working towards making that happen in future.
I think this is a right time for Africa, you know, to come on the world map, that the sport is now recognized and the federations, if they're working, the government comes in, so that there is a bigger movement, you know.
It's our dream. Every b-boy it has that dream to be on that stage in Olympic.
And they are confident that Kigali's dancers have both the talent and the will to make it.